Welcome to the first section of this course. Here, we will be equipping ourselves with essential mathematical knowledge required to understand how options pricing models are derived. In this video lecture, we will discuss a popular technique for pricing an option using binomial trees. A binomial tree is a diagram that flows from one starting node into two nodes and continues the same for n layers. In this case, the binomial tree represents different possible paths that the underlying might follow in the lifespan of the option. An assumption here is that the underlying follows a random walk, that is, future price movements are independent of past price movements. At each step in the binomial tree, there is a defined probability of the underlying either moving up or moving down by a certain percentage amount. There could be many steps in the tree, depending on how complex a model we want to create. Let us start by looking at a simple one-step model, using an example of a European call option. We are interested in finding the price of a European call option, with a strike price of 110 rupees, expiring in 3 months. Assume that the underlying stock price is valued at 100 rupees at present. At the end of the 3 months, there will be two scenarios. Either the stock price moves to 120 rupees, which makes the option worth 10 rupees, or the stock price moves to 80 rupees, in which case the option expires worthless. We assume two conditions, the first being that arbitrage opportunities do not exist. We will set up a portfolio in such a way that there is no uncertainty about the value of the portfolio at the end of 3 months. The next condition is that because the portfolio has zero risk, the return it earns must be equal to the risk-free interest rate. This means, this portfolio will give us the same returns as a risk-free bank deposit. Let us understand this better with an example. First, let us understand the no-arbitrage assumption, which implies that there should not exist any opportunity to make risk-free profit. Assuming this happens, irrespective of the market movement, that is, stock price moving up or down, the payoff from the risk-free portfolio, containing the underlying and the option, should remain the same. Consider a position where we buy delta number of shares of the underlying stock, and sell one call option. We will compute the value of delta, which makes this a risk-free portfolio. We will equate the values of the two outcomes after 3 months. In the first case, when the stock price is at 120 rupees, and the value of the option is 10 rupees, the value of our portfolio is 120 times delta, minus 10. In the second case, when the stock price is at 80 rupees, the value of our long position is 80 delta, and the option expires worthless, hence the portfolio has a value of 80 delta. On equating these two cases, 120 delta minus 10 is equal to 80 delta, which implies 40 delta is equal to 10. We see that when delta is equal to 0.25, we can create a risk-free portfolio. You can substitute this value of delta in both the cases and see that the value of our portfolio remains to be 20 rupees after 3 months in either outcomes. Let us use the assumption that a risk-free portfolio must have its returns equal to the risk-free interest rate. The present value of the portfolio will be calculated by discounting the value of the portfolio 3 months in the future, which we have seen to be 20 rupees. Let us assume the risk-free interest rate to be 10% and the time period to be discounted by is 3 months or 1 divided by 4 years. The present value of the portfolio would be 20 multiplied by exponential raised to the power of negative 0.10 multiplied by 1 divided by 4. Therefore, the present value of the portfolio is equal to 19 rupees and 50 paise. Next, substituting this value in the equation that we had constructed, we will get 19.50, which is equal to 100 multiplied by 0.25 minus the price of the option. By rearranging, we can compute the price of the option as 25 minus 19.5, that is 5 rupees and 50 paise. We can extend this analysis to a two-step binomial tree as shown in the diagram. At each step, we make an assumption that the price can either go up or down by 20%. The time scale for each step is 3 months, and the option has 6 months to expiration. At the end of the first step, The underlying might either be priced at 120 rupees or 80 rupees. This is the same as the example we have seen previously. At the next step, that is at the time of expiration, the underlying might be at either 144 rupees, 96 rupees or 64 rupees. This is computed using the assumption that the prices can either go up or down by 20%. Now, for computing the option price, we will sequentially compute the price of the option, first at 3 months in the future at points P and C, following which, we will then compute the price of the option today at point A. The value or price of the option at points C, E, and F will be zero, as the option will expire out of the money if it takes the bottom path. The price of the option at point B will be computed by considering the branch PDE to be a one-step binary tree. Once we compute the price at point B, we will consider the ABC branch and compute the option price at point A. We will apply our learnings from the one-step binary tree example twice to arrive at the option price at point A. Applying this methodology, the fair value of the option is computed to be 10 rupees and 26 paise. You can try this as an exercise by computing the values yourself. In the upcoming units, there will be a couple of multiple choice questions to test your understanding of binomial trees. Following which, you will be provided with some reading material on the derivation of BSM using binomial tree, and another reading unit on Wiener process and Itô's lemma. Keep learning!